every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Well, good morning, grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice. We will be glad in it. Lamentations chapter number 3, verse 23 says that the mercy of God, the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you and I. God is faithful. Every day we wake up, it's not only a brand new day that he has made for us, but it is indeed a fresh start. We have spent, if I can say it that way, all of the mercy that he's extended to us. We've spent that on yesterday, which is why he refreshes us with mercy for today. I want to talk to you for just a moment. I'm not going to put up a scripture this morning, but I want to talk to you for just a moment because in many cases, the day after Thanksgiving is considered to be Black Friday, and there's a lot of sales that have gone on. Some of you may have tried to get some sales in, you know. I don't think it's as big as it used to be since a lot of us are shopping online now. But when I think about this whole concept of Black Friday, I could go into the connotation of black and other colors and how everything that's negative seems to be black. You know, the villain is in black. We have black male and all the things that seem to be considered to be negative are associated seemingly with the color of black. Now, I'll tell you, black is my favorite color. It has become a little problematic because a lot of the things that I do have, they're black. And sometimes when I'm looking for something and if everything is black, it's kind of hard to find it. So I may have to break up my little color scheme. But black is my favorite color. The idea, though, that black is considered to be something as a color that's associated with things that are negative. I really want us to be mindful that during this time, during this season, this particular holiday season, from Thanksgiving through the Christmas season, and maybe even a week or two after the New Year, and really, more than just someone, there are a lot of people who struggle during this time. While everyone is seemingly happy and with family and friends and all of those kinds of things, I want us to be mindful of those who are not as joyful as others. Some of you have saw in the news, and I have not said much about it, but I think I was on a plane when I saw the news or out of town, and I saw how 1,500 workers were surprisingly, you know, laid off of their job here in Western New York. And I have not followed the story, so there may be things that have happened since that time. But a lot of families who had to experience that, who are part of that 1,500. Can you imagine 1,500 employees affected by one decision? Some have, you know, I was reading online. Yeah, I know. I was on a plane. Yeah, I remember now. I was on a plane and we hadn't taken off yet. And so I'm scrolling through Facebook and I saw the article and I started going through the article. And some people actually found out they lost their job through Facebook. There are a lot of people who are going through a challenging season, challenging moment. And I don't want this Friday to be a Black Friday for you. I want to give you a reason again to give God thanks and to give him praise. We shared on yesterday that the phrase, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever." That was our scripture on yesterday. But I want to pause and say to someone who may be listening to me this morning, and you're starting this day, and maybe, just maybe, this is the first Thanksgiving season, the first holiday season without something that or someone that means so much to you. I want to remind you that God said in his word, God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. I don't want you to allow this holiday season to become so overwhelmingly dark that you miss out on what God is doing and what God has already done. Instead of just lamenting what I don't have and who's no longer with us, let me be reminded of the good time that I had with the person who may have transitioned. Let me be mindful that whatever I do have that may not seem to be enough, someone else who has less than I have, and they have found a reason to give God thanks and to give him the praise. And so I wanted to pause and just take a moment and allow us to reflect in this moment. Don't allow this season to become overwhelmingly heavy. Spend time with family. Spend time with friends. Do something that brings joy in your life. Don't be afraid. Don't be so spiritual as to not take time, and even in those difficult moments, to take your burden to the Lord and leave them there. I trust that this made sense. I know it's a little different than what we would normally do, but I don't want this Friday. I don't want this season to become so overwhelmingly dark that you fail to remember what God is doing and what God has already done. Listen, that's all the time that I have for you this morning. I trust that I'll see you tomorrow as we continue to walk through the Word of God. God willing, I'll see you in the morning. God bless. This is the good news.